The question is why I'm creating this video. And basically, I'm creating this video because I read many books about project management. I watched videos. I followed some people, and I tried to learn how to do the project management from all the kind of sources. But I can tell you, it's in reality it's different. And in reality, I had to come up with my own way how to actually manage a project. And in this video, I would like to talk about the project what we have been developing over 2 years. And in this video, I would like to point out the things which I found useful, and I really hope they may help also you or other people to build your own projects. In this video, I'm going to explain what are the things which didn't work. Many of these were from the books what I read before, especially like planning and all these things what never work in reality. And I will also highlight the things what I found like super useful and what really moved my project ahead. I also would like to talk about the steps or the directions what you may keep thinking about when you will be developing your own project, like what to develop first, why to develop specific things first, and then what next, what kind of next feature you would like to develop, why it is important. And in this video, I'm not going to talk about how to build a huge project in big companies with investors and a lot of money. In this video, I'm going to talk about the project which has to make money. The project which has to focus on delivering results and the ways how we get the results. How we are building this project the way that it actually makes money for itself and pays for the development. And the project is really, really huge. I told you, we started the development around 2.5 years ago, and yeah, there was a lot what I learned, and that's what I would like to share with you in this video. I really hope you will find this useful, and I really hope some of this information, or at least some of this information, will help you to maybe build your own project, will help you to maybe improve some management skills, or you will get some ideas how to manage your own projects. Here is the video. What do you think how this development of big project starts? You buy the whiteboard, you mount it on the wall, and you start writing there and, you know, start coding and working on your project. That's not actually how I started my project. My project actually started like 4 years ago, when I really came up with this idea which I wanted to build. And I started looking for a software engineer. And this was like huge problem. It took me almost 2 years to find the right person which would help me to actually build this project. So first, very important thing, if you are going to build a huge project, you need to find the right people. The kind of people what are not going to leave after 1 year and just leave you with unfinished project, and then you can start again. Yeah, you need to find people what are not going to work just to get salary or get paid, but they are going to work on the project because they believe in the project and they would like to finish this project. This is like super, super important. This was one of my biggest worries when I started working on this project. I was really worried that the software engineer will leave before the project is in the stage when it will start making money. Because it happened to me before. I paid a software engineer to design a website for me, and he finished like 95% of the website and then he left, and I was not able to start selling the services through the website because it was not finished. And I paid this software developer all the salaries and everything. I wasted all my money and he just left me with this unfinished project. So, very big, important first step, find people what are going to help you to build this, your idea. People what are not going to leave you, at least before they finish something what is going to start making money. And then you can start growing your project more and more. Okay? Don't forget, find the great people. Once I found the right software engineer, we started the development. And the development started in July 2018. And the first two things what we did were planning and evaluation. Planning, you know, I really wanted to do it right. I really wanted to talk about what we are going to develop because I knew it's going to be super complicated. And I really thought like this kind of proper planning is going to help me to build this huge project. What a wasted time. Basically, for first 2 months, every Monday, we had this huge meeting. In this meeting, we used the whiteboard. Here you can see pictures from all the kind of whiteboards what we created during these meetings every Monday for 2 months. And I can tell you, I have never, ever checked what is on these pictures. If I would be doing this again, I would not spend so much time on planning. I would spend time maybe talk about what we are building, what will be all the kind of possibilities of the project, what we should keep in mind when we are creating this project, just to know where it can grow and what it can become. But I would definitely not speak about like specific features or how to implement these specific features. I will explain a little bit later in the video how you can be deciding on what to implement next in your big project, okay? But it is definitely not beginning of your project. In beginning of your project, you have no idea what kind of features you will really need at what stage of your project, and you have no idea about how exactly they are going to be implemented. The second thing, as I mentioned, was evaluation. Basically, I knew this is going to be a huge project, which will be used, I don't know, next 5 or 10 years. So I knew we have to use latest technology to create this project. And this means we had to come up with some ideas what we would like to use to build this project, what kind of technology. And we had to evaluate this technology. We had to build some kind of mock-up project where we could test all the kind of, at least the basic features, what we needed in our big project. So in first 3 months, we also created this kind of super simple project just to test the main features, what we needed in our real project. After 2 years of looking for a software engineer, and after 3 months of working on this mock-up project and useless planning, finally, after these 2 years and 3 months, I could start with development of the big project. Until now, I have not really explained what kind of project we were working on. And the reason why is because if I would tell you this is about software development, and if you are not doing software development, you would be like, oh, this video is not for me. But this video is not about software development, okay? The points from this video, they can actually apply on all the kind of different developments. Important is, this video is about development of a huge project. And when I say huge project, I mean, it's the kind of project where you don't know exactly what you are actually developing, because the project is so big that it's not possible to write the exact specification what you would like to develop. The project is so big that you don't know exactly what kind of features you are going to have in the final product, or how the final product is going to exactly look. And that's what is this video about. Developing the project which you don't know exactly how it is going to look when it is finished. This, what you can see here, this is what we were developing. And very simply to say, it is a website or portal where people can watch online courses. And this is like super simple explanation. The project is much more complex. You will see it later in this video. Now, after the unsuccessful planning and after the evaluating the technology what we would like to use, we need to start the development. But the question is, how, where, what to do first? What would you do? How you would start this kind of project? You have no idea how the final product is going to look, so where to start? What we did, we bought very expensive project management system, because you cannot create huge project without a proper management system, right? No, I'm just kidding. What we actually did, we created Google Docs document with to-do list. I'm not saying this is going to work for everyone, okay? Especially if you have like big team and many people are working on the project, then maybe this is not the way how you would like to manage your project. But in our case, I was surprised how well this to-do list works as a project management system. Even we are developing huge thing, just simple to-do list works perfectly fine. And this is an example. I copied and pasted some of the things from our to-do list so you can see how it looks. So this is an example how we started our development. Basically, we decided on the core of the project what we were building. In our case, because it's a website for to watch online courses, the core is basically playing the video. Okay, and in this first milestone, we decided that our core system is going to support registration of new students, then login of these students. We should be able to activate a course for the students. They should be able to watch the video and possibly download the resources for the course. So these are the essentials what we really needed for our huge system. And we also decided that the website what we were building is not going to be only for students, but it can be used also by other instructors, by other people who could simply place on this website their own courses. So in this first milestone, we not only wanted to have support for students, but also very basic support for instructors. So they could add a new course, edit the course or delete the course, and publish the course. And this is exactly where we started. This is what helped us to create all the tasks which we needed to accomplish to actually meet this goal. Okay, so this is how we started. We specified the core, the minimum of our huge project, and we focus only to build this minimum in this very first step. Notice how simple this specification is. It is like super, super simple. The students, they can't even buy the courses. There is no payment. There are no emails, no notifications. There is nothing, just watching the video. In your case, this core should be something similar. Okay? So, for your huge project, think what is the core of the project. What everyone will use, why you are building this huge project. And that should be the very first step what you may want to implement. After a couple of months of development, we created this. And I was like, but you know, this is missing and this is missing and we cannot release this because also this is missing and this one. And we started developing more and more features. and we have got trapped. After 1 year of development, this website was much more bigger, but it was still not making any money. And even after 1 year of development, I was like, but it's not ready. There is still this missing, this. And I couldn't see when this website will start making money. Be very careful about this. When you finish your core development, ask yourself if you cannot really make any money on your product. Because maybe you can. You know what happened? I've got very lucky. After 1 year, something terrible happened. Yeah, I've got lucky because something terrible happened. So after 1 year of development, when I was like, we are still not ready, we cannot start selling courses through this new portal because it's not ready. After 1 year, our old portal completely crashed. And there was no other way. We had to start selling our courses through this new portal. And within 1 week, we did it. Within 1 week, this new portal started making money. Even I thought it's not ready. It was. And maybe this portal could start making money even half year before. Be very careful about this. Don't get trapped in development. Maybe your product, maybe your project can actually start making money much sooner than you would think. Okay, there are not all the features, but you can do many features or many things what you need to have in your product or in your project. You can do them manually. You would be surprised how many things we had to do manually. We had to create invoices manually. We had to generate downloads or many other things. We had to do them manually. It was not fully automatic on the website, but the website was making money. And I learned something at this moment. I learned how to continue with the development. I learned what kind of new features we would like to implement. How to decide what is important and what is not. And that's what we are going to talk about next. What do you think? How did I know what features are important to implement next? Because we had real customers. And suddenly, everything was clear. Before, we had to guess what kind of features our customers will need. We thought that these are important features. But reality may be completely different. And once we had the real customers, then all our next tasks, they were very clear. We had clear to-do list with priorities, and we immediately knew we have to do this, then this, then this, and this. For example, on the top of our list was to improve payments. Initially, we knew we were losing money because if someone wanted to buy one of our courses, they had to contact us. We had to send them pro forma invoice, then some links which they used to pay the money, and it was super complicated. So on the top of our list was make it easier for our customers to pay for our product. And then next one on the list was to improve user experience. So, for example, to finish the courses, we knew they would like to get certificates. So we immediately knew we have to add some features to support certificates. Then next on the list were the tasks which were taking me a lot of time to do. Then next on the list were tasks which were taking a lot of time our team to do, like invoices. After each payment, we had to create and send invoice to every single customer. And it was taking a lot of time. It was a lot of work, and it could be very easily generated automatically. This was a super important. Get your first customers as soon as possible, because this will help you to immediately see what you need to work on, and you will immediately see what are the priorities and features what you need to do. It's like much, much better, and it may be much different from what you think you should be doing on your product. When we were developing these new features to improve user experience on our portal, I knew that to grow our huge project, we need to find new companies or new instructors who would be using our portal for online courses. So once you have this core, then think what you need to do next to grow your project and work on this. In our case, it was to find these companies or these new instructors. And I've got very lucky again. I have got contacted by big university in Australia, and they were actually interested to use one of my courses, and we offered them our platform, and now they are basically using our portal or our website to teach their students. And what did I learn from this? Or what is interesting about this? Very interesting is that it was not so difficult to actually create support for this university. We only created a couple of new features, and once this university started using these new features, they paid us money. So these new features, we immediately knew what kind of features we need to develop. We immediately knew what are the priorities for the new features, what we need to work on, because we wanted to get this university as a customer. And once these features were finished, they were immediately paid. Why this is important? Because when you will be working on your big project, maybe you really don't want to develop features, some features which maybe someone will use sometime in future. This is what was so really, really good on this university, because they helped us to focus on the development which was immediately paid and which was immediately used. And same way, we started developing additional features because we found a new instructor. You know him. It's Steve Sandler. I have created a couple of YouTube videos with Steve, and he created an online course which is hosted on our website, on our new platform. And once we knew that Steve would like to use our platform, we immediately knew what kind of features we need to implement. And once we implemented this feature, We got also some payment through the sales of the Steve's courses. So implementation or development of this feature was partially paid. It was not fully paid yet, but it is still much better than developing features which you don't know when they will be paid. And also this feature was what we just developed for Steve, they can be used also for another instructor and another and another. So we can reuse these features. We don't need to do any additional work, and we can use these features for other instructors which can pay us some money. Of course, these features, they are not like super fully implemented. There is still a lot of work for full automatization, as it was also when we were starting with our users. But as number of instructors will grow, then we will implement more and more automatization. At this moment, we have to do a lot of things manually, but it's fine because we are not going to implement features which we may use in future and we don't need them right now. So, what are the next features what we need to develop? We have these features for the university, for the next instructor. What next? What would you develop as a next feature? At this stage of development, it's getting more complicated. At this stage of development, there are a number of things what you need to consider when deciding what kind of feature create next. Basically, there are like three big areas what you where you need to balance your time and development. The first area is improving existing product. So you need to listen to your customers, you need to listen to your team, and keep improving. Ideally, you would like to create features which will help your customers and which will also help to you. For example, one of these kind of feature was notification. We implemented notifications which are now helping our users because they get notified that, for example, their certificate is ready. And it also helps our team because our team they don't need to send emails to students and telling them their certificate is ready. Yeah, so this is just one example what kind of features can improve your portal, and it can improve your user experience, and also it can help you. Then the second area, what is very important to consider in this stage of development is optimization. As your product grows, then you may find out that some of the things what you have implemented, they are just not. You need to redo them because they were built for the situation when your product or your project was very small, and now it's just not enough. So you have to go back to something what you already done, and you have to redo it. And the third area where you may want to implement new features are the features which are going to bring you money. This doesn't necessarily mean it's something bad for your users. You are going to now take money from your users or something. No. For example, this can be the kind of feature which will, for example, show your current users all the kind of courses which we have on our platform. And this way, this is the kind of feature which can make money because we can maybe sell more courses, and it's not bad for users because they can actually find something more, they can actually find more useful courses. It's not something we would be lying to them or trying to trick them or something. No. It can help our users, we can make money, and also our instructors can be more happy. Everyone wins. So watch for these kind of features, which when you implement them, then multiple different groups of people can benefit from these features. Now, about the money, it may look like now you would like to make money because you are building this your project. No, it's not about this. If you would like to grow your project, you need more money because you need to grow also your team. When your project grows, you need more and more people to help you to grow your product, to grow your project. And for this, you need more money. It's all in cycle. It's all connected together. Before we finish, I would like to say a couple of words. And first, I would like to motivate you. If you think you are too small to work or create a huge project, what do you think, how big is our company? We are just 5 people, me or myself, software engineer, 2 people who are helping me with support, and my wife, she is helping me mostly with certificates. So just 5 people. I'm not saying this project, what we have created at this moment, it's huge or big, but I believe it's on the way to keep growing, and that's important. So if you think you are too small for building something huge, no, I don't think so. Everyone can do it. You just need to think how to do it. Of course, this is only one way how you can do it, like make money and use this money to grow the project. Other way is to find investors, but that's not what I feel comfortable with. And I like to, you know, develop in my own speed and especially do not stress. And when I'm saying about the speed of development, don't be surprised if your development is going to be slower than what you thought, because that's what is going to happen. Okay, if you think you are going to build this huge project in 1 year, then maybe that's not what is going to happen. Be prepared, it may take much, much longer, and the development is going to be much slower. Also, when you will be working on your own project, you will need to spend a lot of time on the project, and you will need to work hard. For example, in our team, my task is to manage the development, but I have to also help with everything what needs to be done. For example, initially, I created this website. I created how our product is going to look. I did it because we don't have any money to pay some professional graphic people. And even if I would have money to pay these people, I don't trust them too much because I like really bad experience from past. And many of them, they don't really deliver what they promise. So initially in our project, we just focus on functionality. So I just sit down, and I was thinking, like, what would be the most simple website which would do what we want to do? And I come up with something like this, and we still keep using it. So in your project, you don't need to be expert to help with in some areas which maybe you would think like, oh, you need expert for this. No, you can do it maybe by yourself and no problem. And we still don't have any professional graphic designer, and people, they don't complain. Actually, when I have a look on some other websites or on some other companies, sometimes it looks to me like if you have this special team for making graphic, they just make the things more complicated. See the recent logos from Google. Sometimes I think they just give them work to do something what even doesn't need to be improved or done or changed. They just change it because they need to do something. But because we are very small, we don't have this luxury to do something just because do something. Sounds maybe confusing, but I hope you understand. So next role or next things what I have to do is, for example, I need to be sure that we still have customers, so we have enough money to keep developing our project. So for example, I'm creating the YouTube videos, and it's taking me a lot of time, but I know that without my work on this project, the project would not grow. And the next thing what I'm working on is to get new instructors who would be using our website. So I have to do a lot of things. If you will be working on your own big project, be prepared, you will have to do a lot of things. There is one more thing what I would like to mention in this video. What I found super useful when managing this project are calls. So every day, every morning, I have a call with my software engineer. The call is between 10 minutes to 45 minutes, depends what we need to talk about. And every single day, we speak about what has been done the day before and what is going to be done this specific day. And this way, I'm able to actually seeing progress every single day on this huge and big project. This is something what I believe is like super important. If I would be having this kind of meeting only once a week or once a month, I believe the progress of the project would not be so great as these calls, as if we have these calls every single day. So maybe if you are working on a project, if you are managing a project, consider something like this, a call every single day with your engineers, because it's like super, super useful. And that's everything for today's video. I really hope you found it useful. I know it was a lot about our own project, but I still believe it can be useful for you, because if I knew what I learned during working on this project, it could really help me to maybe do some things differently from beginning. For example, I wouldn't spend so much time on the initial planning, because now I know it was wasted time. Yeah? And I would maybe release the project to public much sooner, because it could start making money after, 5 months of development instead of waiting 1 year. These are the things what maybe you can learn from this video. Let me know what you think about this topic, what you found useful when working on big project or when managing big project. What is super useful for you? How you decide what is going to be implemented next? How you work on project with no full specification? Because it can be super complicated. So I'm really curious, and maybe your comments can help also other people. Okay, if you like this video, don't forget press like button. If you have your own project in your mind, go for it. I would like to thank you very much for watching and see you next time. Bye. Wait. I completely forgot. I wanted to say that if you would be interested to help us to grow this project, then let me know, okay? We are especially looking for companies would like to host online courses, and we are looking for new instructors or for people who would be interested to create online courses and host them on our Fedevel education portal. If you are interested, then go on Fedevel Education, click on contact, you can fill out this contact form, or you can send me email to info@fedevel.com. And that's it. That's really the end of this video. So thank you again and bye.